Video 16, reinforcement for beam. In the previous lesson, we drew the reinforcement of the wall with steps from shape the rebar, place and label the rebar. And today's lesson, we will proceed to continue creating rebar for the next structural component, reinforced concrete beams. As you know, beams are an important structural component of a building structure in Vietnam. Basic design, we have the stirrup and rebars. Of course, there will be many rules about rebar structure for beams. Here, I will implement a rule that has been used by some places in the world for a typical beam drawing in our building. First, you also proceed to determine the beams you need to draw, marking beams and creating basic sections. A beam plan view with a scale of 100. A beam elevation view with a scale of 150. Beam cross section at supports and in the span of scale 120. As well as checking the dimension and elevation symbols before drawing rebar as I create here. You turn to the rebar's drawing as follows. You also use the bar shape tool. To make stirrups, as with columns. You click on the symbol, select the type of stirrups, for example, the type of stirrup, select the diameter and concrete cover. Then, put in the created cross section. Press Escape to move through the rebar placing step, which extends over the entire length and is 50 millimeters from each end of the beam. Choose a distance, for example 150 millimeters. And we also increase the amount of rebar on both ends of the beam, similar to the column. The distance at the two ends of the beam will be 100 millimeters. In the middle is 150 millimeters. You do as you would with stirrup. Then you show a representative bar and label the rebar stirrup. Once you have created the rebar stirrup, you create straight bars along the bottom and top layers. Use the bar shape command and select the straight bars. Select diameter, 16, and extend the beam length. Next is to place the rebar according to the existing rebar section stirrup. You choose the number is 2 in 2 corners. With the bottom rebar, we will reinforce a section of rebar in the spans. So you refer on existing reinforcement bars, copy into new reinforcement bars, move to the right position. And change mark with new bar mark tool. Click on the rebar you want to change and enter a new mark. Full schema mark number 3 and resize it. The length will be 2700 millimeters. Use the stretch command to resize it. $4,500 to $2,700. Then move rebar number 3 to the right position. Next, we have create schema or bar mark 2 and put it below. These rebars must be anchored to beams with sufficient length. In this case, you add a piece of rebar to the Mark Rebar tool at Add Bar Segment. Select the end of the rebar and click the next point about 250 millimeters, then stretch if not exactly the length. You stop the rebar within the specified range with the marker here, with the bar end mark tool. You label these rebars for quantity and diameter. The top layer does the same thing. You create new rebar with bar shape. Place rebar. You create a new rebar mark for symmetrical reinforcing bars and place them at two support. Note there is a gap and avoid collisions. Please adjust the dimension for accuracy. You take this symmetrical rebar mark. We use add bar segment and stretch to adjust the dimension for the correct rebar mark with number 4. At this time, we label the stop symbol for the Mark V rebar as before. It's the same in the cross-section position, but we removed the long flash mark. Finally, you show schema right in the section to manage the number and dimension rebars. can add some other 2D comments if needed, like this from the Wizard palette. Thus, we have created and presented reinforcement in a typical reinforced concrete beam. In the next class, I will present to you reinforced concrete slabs with a new approach.